So, welcome to this yoga practice. And today we will journey with whales as we practice the wild, beautiful whales. So I invite you to find a comfortable place to sit, to lay down, it's your choice, where you can take in this poem called Whales Weep Not by D.H. Lawrence. They say the sea is cold, but the sea contains the hottest blood of all, and the wildest, the most urgent. All the whales in the wider deeps, hot are they as they urge on and dive beneath the icebergs. The right whales, the sperm whales, the hammerheads, the killers, there they blow. There they blow. Hot, wild, white breath of the sea. And they rock through the sensual ageless ages on the depths of the seven seas. And through the salt they reel with drunk delight. And in the tropics tremble they with love. And roll with massive, strong desire like gods. And enormous mother whales lie dreaming, suckling their whale tender young, and dreaming with strange whale eyes wide open in the waters of the beginning and the end. And all this happens in the sea, in the salt, where God is also love, but without words. And Aphrodite is the wife of whales, most happy, happy she. And Venus among the fishes skips and is a she-dolphin. She is the gay, delighted porpoise sporting with love in the sea. She is the female tunnyfish, round and happy among the males, and dense with happy blood. Dark rainbow bliss in the sea. Rainbow bliss in the sea. These massive beings, from the gray whales down to the small dolphins, are breathers of air just like we are, although they live in a fluid environment. So today, as we practice, we're going to connect with two things, focus on two things, and that is breath. Fluid motion. So I'd like to invite you into child's pose. Your head, your forehead on the floor, and kneeling with your knees open so that your heart can be cradled in that beautiful space as you bow down to your own life, to the greater life that we are all part of. And breathe. And as you are in child's pose, think of your favorite watery environment. Maybe it's a river or a lake, are a sea. Regardless, all water is connected. Whether it starts at a mountain stream and you connect with it there as it trickles down to become a creek, rushing into a river that rushes down and down connecting with larger rivers that rush down and down to the sea. The ocean refuses no river. The ocean refuses no river. It is all one, the water on our planet. So as we practice, think of oneness that connects us all, that river of life, the river of breath. And come up and bring your hands to your heart in prayer position. And open your hands so that your pinky and thumb and wrist are connected, but your hands are open to receive the beauty, the oneness. And then bring your hands up overhead as you rise up on your knees, keeping that open container of your hands as you lift up. Allowing the river of breath to fill your hands, and then bringing that river down through your crown, your throat, your heart, your solar plexus, your belly, your knees, bringing that breath all the way down to the earth. And finding that rhythm of breath as you bring your arms up, separating your hands overhead. And bringing that breath down, that river of breath that connects us all. Everything is connected with water, and with breath. Even plants breathe. Beautiful, connected. Just flow with that breath of rising up and bringing that breath down into the earth, that river of life. And then come into hero's pose if you can. If that's not comfortable for you, if you can't lower your seat or it's uncomfortable for your knees, you can bring a bolster under your seat. But I invite you to explore the idea of being connected through breath with all life. Just as the whales teach us as they come up to the surface to breathe and then dive deep into the silence. Come up to the surface to breathe. And then dive deep into the silence of the deep water within you. The deep, beautiful stillness. Even when the storms are raging at the surface, the depths of the ocean are still. Stillness within you. Where is it in your body? Breathe in the breath of life and find that stillness as you dive deep. And then come into all fours, flat back. Breathing in as you look up and arch your back like a cow, dropping your belly. And then exhale as you lower your head, look back towards your belly, but your belly's moving up like a cat. And just be in that flow of breath. Breathing in at the surface, exhaling, diving deep as you lower your head. Coming to surface, lifting your head. you lower your head. Find that rhythm like the rhythm of the whales as they are moving. You can see their backs come up out of the water as they breathe, and then they dive. And then they come up again and breathe and dive. Find that rhythm in cat and cow. But feel that whale energy. Invite it in to all your practice today as we create space for that massive whale energy to come in and be with us. And then find a neutral space, like a whale that lounges at the surface, allowing the sun to warm their back. Feel that. Connect with that beautiful whale energy. Delight in the sun. Or maybe it's starlight. Maybe that's what you imagine as a whale touching your back. White hot stars, light years away, bringing light, guiding your navigation of migration. Imagine a baby whale being born in the waters and coming up to the surface at night to see the stars. Imagine what that must be like, being in that warm, watery environment of birth. And the first thing you see is starlight, reminding you of where you came from and where you will return. And look back left as you stretch out the side body on the right, imagining that as a whale, how you would have pectoral fins on the side, and how you would be stretching those massive. Humpback whales have 15-foot long wings or fins, 15 feet each. And then look back right, stretching out the left side body. I call humpback whales angels because of their white wings, their white pectoral fins. And then go back left, looking over your left shoulder. And one more time to the right. And then coming into a squat position, finding a way to lift to support your heels if they don't quite stretch to the floor. But if they do, allow them to in that squat. Maybe your hands can go under your heels if they don't quite stretch that far. Opening our colon. Such an important stretch. You can also use a block. From that squat, gradually, slowly rising, allowing those huge pectoral fins, also known as your arms, to rise up and up, up to the surface, up, and then allow them to come down to your sides. Stand in mountain pose. Arms at your side, relaxed shoulders and neck. And then bring your arms up overhead again. with your right hand grasping your left wrist. Lean over to the right, stretching the left side. Opening that side body even more. Breathing with the river of life. And then come up and switch hands. Left hand holds right wrists. Lean left, stretching that right side body. Feeling the breath of life enter that space. And then come up. Allow your beautiful arms to float down as you swan dive into a forward fold. Coming up partway like you're surfacing to breathe at the surface of the warm ocean. And exhaling as you forward fold one more time. Rising up like a whale coming from the depths, bringing your arms overhead, breathing in that breath of life. And then lowering your arms to your sides in mountain pose. Step back right a little bit with your right foot. Angling your foot out a little bit to the right. Bringing your arms up overhead for warrior one. A slight arch to your back as you lean into that left knee, keeping the knee in alignment with your ankle or a little behind the ankle. Warrior one, opening to breath, opening to life. And then bring your hands to your heart. Take a quarter turn to the right and unfold into warrior two, dropping that back foot back further, pointing the toes more towards the long edge of the mat, finding your place of comfort. Strong arms, gaze over the right hand, left hand, sorry about that. Gazing over that left hand. Turn that left hand up. And imagine as you lift it that you are swimming in a sea of breath in the warm ocean and dropping that right hand down so that at some point you come to a perpendicular place where your hands are reaching one into heaven, the other towards the earth. In the middle of the ocean, you feel this, and then lean back with your left hand coming back over your head, opening even more. And then coming forward back into warrior two, dropping that left elbow on the left thigh, bringing the right arm up behind you into side angle, and then extending that arm up overhead, opening into that river of breath, the river of life. Then come back into warrior two. Turn so that you face forward, your right foot pivots towards the front, and then step with your feet together. Arms at your side, and then come up, breathing, coming to the surface of the ocean. Forward fold, diving to the depths of the sea. Inhaling as you come up halfway. And then exhaling as you dive deep into that ocean of life once more. Inhale and come up, raising your arms up overhead like you're surfacing after a long dive into the depths of the stillness. And then gently drop your arms. Step back left a little bit, angling the left foot a little out to the long side of your mat. Arms up overhead into warrior one. Left foot back. a little arch to the back as you reach your arms back. And then drop your arms gently to your heart. Take a quarter turn to the left and open up into Warrior Two, dropping your left foot back. Front knee bent, but not going past the ankle. Strong arms. Gaze over your right hand. And then allow your right hand to turn up. And like you're swimming in the depths of the ocean, raise that hand up overhead while your left hand goes down. And so your right hand touches the sky. Your left hand touches the bottom of the sea. And you are in the middle swimming in the ocean of life. Allow your right hand to come back over your head as you open that side body. And then come back into Warrior Two. And then drop your right arm, resting it on your right thigh, bringing up your left hand so you can do side angle pose, stretching again. It feels so good to stretch in that fluid environment. And come back into Warrior Two. Pivot that left foot forward. Bring your arms together, step together. Hands to the side. And then raising them up from the depth of the sea. Raising them up to the surface and breathing. Breathing. And then gently allow your arms to flow down like in the water. You feel that resistance of the ocean. Just allow your arms to drop to your sides. Breathe the river of life as it flows down into the ocean. Feel that in your body as you stand in mountain pose. That river of life moving through you, through everything, connecting us all. And then transfer your weight to your right foot. And we're going to bend our left leg and bring our knee up towards the waist in a balanced pose, keeping your arms to your sides, fingers out strong. If you want to touch a toe down for balance, that's totally fine. Take care of yourself. Be your own best friend here. Challenge yourself, but also nurture yourself. And then gently, gently drop that left foot down. Transfer the weight into your left foot as you raise your right knee up. Strong arms at your sides. Left knee coming towards the waist, holding in balance. And then stepping down back into mountain pose. Again, allowing that breath, that river of life to move through you. Originating in the stars and spiraling down through your body, all the way down to the bottom of the sea, the earth of the sea. Grounding your feet into the sandy bottom of the sea. Allowing yourself to move to the song of the sea. To the music that resides in all things. Breathing the river of life then gently, like you're diving a slow dive in warm ocean water, dive down into a forward fold, and gently, ever so gently, step your feet back into down dog, and walk your dog, stretching the back of your legs, lifting your heels off the bottom of the sea. Feeling the salty water surround you, or maybe the river water or lake, whatever water you connect with, bring it into the practice, the fluid practice today. And then raise your right foot behind you, and let that hip open as you drop that foot over to the left, opening your beautiful hip, and then bring it back to center, and we're going to transfer our weight forward and back a few times, so we won't be planting our foot, just bringing your weight forward into your arms and hands, and then pushing back. And your knee will need to stay up close off the floor if possible. So just flow with that, feeling your strength as you move forward, holding that knee up, and then push back. Fluid movement, gentle movement. Forward and back. As you breathe in the breath of life, the river of life that connects us all, and back. And then stay in down dog for just a moment, resting here, feeling your breath. And then raise your left leg up behind you, and then drop it over to the right, opening that hip. Breathing. Coming back to center. That same flow of pushing forward, allowing our weight to move forward. Bringing our knee up and then moving back. Just be in that flow of really fluid movement. Very gentle, very controlled. Very strong in your being, in your core. Up and back. Back and forth. And then come back into down dog. Pause here a moment. And then gently walk your feet forward into a forward fold. And then rise up, arms overhead, going from the depths of the sea to a beautiful breach as you come out of the water and breathe once again. And then drop your arms to your sides, standing again in mountain pose. Noticing any place in your body that might want support right now. It may be tight, it may feel constricted, it may hurt. So I'm gonna invite you to bring your hands to that place now and place your hands there. And if you have no such place, then I'm gonna invite you to put your hands in a place of your choosing that might want support. Maybe your heart, maybe your throat, and breathe in that river of life that connects us all. The beautiful river of life. Supporting the places within you that call, that long for attention and support. Giving them your full attention now. Breathing into those places affirming that you care so deeply for your beautiful body, the container while you're here on this planet of your beautiful soul. Breathe. Nothing else to do but breathe. Sending that message, I love you, to your body. Thank you. I'm here for you. I'm listening to you. I'm listening to you. And then gently, ever so gently, side and find a way to the floor. And as you sit, allow your legs to be stretched out in front of you with your toes pointing towards the sky. And then bring your right foot in towards your seat, knee up, reach forward with your arm in front of that knee, and then make a hook with your right arm to go around your knee. If you can, do your very best. If you can't, you can modify it and just hold out straight. And then reach that hand back, and with your left hand, reach around the back. So you're going to be twisting. And try to find that right hand. And if you can't find that hand, it's fine. Just do a nice twist, being gentle and kind with yourself. Breathing into that twist. And then open up. Bring your right foot out in front of you. Legs parallel. Arms come up overhead as you inhale to reach the surface. The sea, and then dive back down towards your toes in a forward fold, diving down into that river of life, breathing, and then come back up. And as you do, bring that left knee up, foot comes towards the left seat. Reach over and around and behind that left leg with your left arm. And the same twist where you reach behind your back with your right. Try to find your fingers. If not, just do a nice twist. You can do that without making a bind out of it. And breathe as you're here. And breathe. And then gradually and slowly allow that left foot to scooch back out. And once more, bring your arms up overhead as you inhale, like you're coming up from a deep dive under the sea. And then forward fold, exhaling. Allowing everything to go into this fold of relaxation. And then gently come up. Inhaling. And then allow yourself to come to a reclined position where you're laying on the floor. And once again, bring your knee up, your right knee up. Reach up with your hands towards your toes, and you might use a strap here or just hold your knee. If you can't reach your toes, it's totally cool. And then gradually allow your right leg to open to the right side. Taking care of your body, allowing yourself to open only as much as is comfortable for you. And then bringing that leg back overhead, gently bending the knee, hugging it into your body, and then stretching it out on the floor. Bring the left knee up, the foot up, the leg up, stretch it out. Reach for those left toes with your left hand, and if you can, touch them. If not, you can use a strap. Same thing. We're going to drop open to the left side. Only going as far as you feel comfortable. And then coming back up, hugging that knee, that left knee, into your chest. And then stretching it out on the floor. Bring both knees in and hug them into your chest. And then extend your feet with your legs bent into happy baby, bringing your arms up on the inside and then holding the outside of your feet. Happy baby. Rocking back and forth. Rocking, and they rock through the central ageless ages on the depths of the seven seas. And through the salt they reel with drunk delight. And in the tropics tremble they with love, and roll with massive, strong desire like gods. Roll in the sea, my friends. Roll in the water. Feel the fluid environment that is your body. Feel the wetness of our moisture of our skin. The fluid that our organs float in within our bodies. They say the sea is cold, but the sea contains the hottest blood of all, and the wildest, and the most urgent. Come back into stillness. Allowing your feet to go out to the sides of your mat, to the ends of your mat, your hands to drop to your sides. Or you can roll to your side, whatever's comfortable for you. And breathe in that environment of fluid bliss. Mother whales lie dreaming, suckling their whale tender young, dreaming with strange whale eyes wide open in the waters of the beginning and the end. Dense, happy blood, dark rainbow bliss in the sea. The river of life longs to breathe you, my friends. Your body longs to be in that place of fluid movement, a fluid stillness. Breathe in the breath of life. Allow it to enter you. Flow freely through you. Attend to any places that are tight or need or want attention. You can move your hands there, or you can just send the breath there, either way, or both. Definitely the breath. Let's send support to these places. Breathe them. Allow the universe to breathe you, because you are part of everything, and everything is a part of you. So for this moment, surrender to being in that place of oneness, allowing the universe to breathe you. And in a moment, I'm going to ask you to roll to one of your sides and gently push up. Before you do that, I'm going to ask that you bring with you the support for your body through your attention and through your intention, that you will listen when your body asks you to slow down or stop, that you will give your body the support it needs through drinking clean, beautiful water to hydrate it well, so that everything feels in a fluid flow. And so when you're ready, sit up slowly, gently, bringing that breath with you, bringing the intention of loving your body, loving yourself. And then place your hands in a position of openness, either on your legs or at your heart. Open your hands to receive this little blessing. As you breathe with me, as we breathe together with all life everywhere. And so this I give you. May we know when to stop and slow down and be quiet, so that we can hear our body as it gives us information. And may we know when our spirit longs for silence and stillness. And may we listen when our soul calls us to breathe with the universe, with all life. And so may it be for you, and so may it be for me, and so may it be for all of us. Thank you for being in this river of life, my friends. Thank you.